This book is Calculus, 9th edition, by James Stewart. Finally, I am in the last chapter, last section, section 16.9, the divergence theorem. I assume you have read the theory in this part of the book. Scroll down. We'll be solving example 1. Flux surface integral equals divergence volume integral. This is Gauss's divergence theorem. We will evaluate flux surface integral, also divergence volume integral. Open up Visual Studio Code. Select empty space. Click this button, 229, divergence, hit enter, click this button, diver.cpp, hit enter, control B, I will close welcome window. Now, drag and drop, calculus, James Stewart. We'll be solving example 1, I will arrange like this. Include CPG, CPG, SCD extensions. Include CPG, CPG, calculus. Namespace CNA, CPG, numerical analysis. Namespace CPT, CPG, types. Void solve. Example 1. Page 1203. Surface flux integral. Int main. Copy the function name. Paste it here. I will copy this function. Paste it here. This is volume divergence integral. Copy, paste. We are computing this part, flux surface integral. Find the flux of the vector field F over the unit sphere. So our surface is a unit sphere. Auto R, CNA, create vector 3D. To do surface integral, we need to take two parameters. I will be using spherical coordinate system, P, auto, theta. This is x coordinate. Return, radius is 1, times SED, sine, phi. This P is polar angle times SED cosine theta. This angle theta is azimuthal angle, comma. I will give line break here. Copy, paste. This is y coordinate. It should be sine theta. Copy, paste. This is z coordinate. Z coordinate should be cosine phi. Remove this part. Remove trailing comma. So our R parameterize our unit sphere or the surface of unit sphere. Now we need to define our vector field F. Auto F CNA create VCTR. This vector field takes x, y, z, three parameters. Auto x, auto y, auto z. X component is z, return z, comma. I will remove the blank space or carriage return. Copy, paste. J component is Y. So we return Y. Copy, paste. Remove trailing comma. This is K component. K component is X. So X. We defined our surface with vector R and vector field F. Vector field F. Now we have to perform flux integral over surface S. We can use auto R P R T R derivative. Then auto flux CNA integral. We perform F R dot R P cross R T. R P cross R T represent D S. F R dot D S. This is our integrand. SED make tuple P represent polar angle. In spherical coordinate system, polar angle runs from 0.0 phi. To use this phi, we have to declare using namespace CPG operators and constant. Also using namespace CNA, we need commands. Now here this represent piece limits the polar angle. Copy, paste. Now we have to specify the range of theta. This theta represent azimuthal angle on XY plane. It should be 2 phi. Theta limits the azimuthal angle. Then we have to specify the meanings of these limits. The theta limits comes last. Then dt for theta limits underscore dp. dp for p limits semicolon. The answer says 4 pi over 3. Auto answer 4.0 times pi over 3. CNA print answer flux surface integral flux. Flux answer. I will remove blank space. We can use any compiler. I will try Microsoft compiler this time. CD 229 divergence. CL EHSC SED C++ 20 DEVR.cpp FE M.exe. Hit enter. CLS M. Our numerical computation matches algebraic answer. Please understand. From vector I that parameterize the surface of unit sphere, we take derivative, then we perform cross product, then dot product. This pattern is used all the time. So I created a surface integral formula. I will disable this part. Now this part can be fixed or simplified like this. R surface integral. Then we can simply pass F. This is much cleaner. Now, I'll be using Clang compiler. Clang++ std c++20 divr.cpp ltbb 12oc.exe hit enter. CLS C. It works perfectly. Now we will solve divergence volume integral. We need to copy this part. Copy, paste here. Also copy vector F. Then paste it here. We will integrate on spherical coordinate system or dv or rho or p or theta semicolon. We capture f. F is this vector or x rho times std sine p times std cosine theta. Copy, paste. This is y. This should be sine theta. Copy, paste. Z. This should be cosine phi. Delete this part. Then we have to take divergence of f like this. Or divergence f. We use del operator. We perform dot. This symbol represent dot operation with del operator. This is divergence of f. We return divergence f by passing x, y, z. This is not good enough. We have to multiply rho square times SED sine phi. Don't miss this factor. This is volume factor on the spherical coordinate system. With this, oro flux equals CNA integral semicolon. We pass this volume differential. It represents volume differential. STD make tuple. Rho represent radial distance in spherical coordinate system. P represent polar angle. Theta represent azimuthal angle. Because this is unit circle, radial distance or radius should run from 0 up to 1. Rho limits. Copy, paste. For phi, the polar angle should run from 0 up to pi. Phi limits. Copy, paste. Now, azimuthal angle theta, it should run 2 pi. Theta limits. Now, for theta limits, dt. For p limits, dp. For rho limits, dr. This is our volume integral. Or answer. This book says the answer is 4 pi over 3. 4 pi over 3. Cine print answer divergence volume integral flux flux answer. Now we build again. CLSC. our divergence volume integral 4.18879 matches flux surface integral. This shows Gauss's divergence theorem is correct.